Just going back a little bit further again to the income statement and then the simplified cash flow in the balance sheet. A couple things to review. When you look at the income statement, what you're looking at is the trends in the top line determine what's available for the operating units to spend in their underlying operations. So as I said, you look at the firm, but you can also look at it as the different elements of the business. Netflix might divide up its business into its DVD distribution business and its streaming business, and it's now has a production business. I just saw they have another film coming out or another series coming out. So they have different businesses, and you can, as we talked about the portfolio view of firms, they can move resources from one business to another. Some of those business units are traditionally treated as the cash source for investments in other businesses, whether it's extending to other countries or not. So you want to look at whether those firms are indeed generating the kinds of gross profits that they can then use that and turn it into operating profit, which can be transferred over into other more growth-oriented businesses that are consuming more cash. You want to keep a clean link. You want to make sure that when you talk about the numbers, they're not sterile, just 23% growth. What does that really mean? Ideally, you want to understand how that 23% growth, how that translates into their unit sales and their pricing on both before and after that growth rate came about, because that might give you some certain signals. There are some additional costs that you have to keep track of. Costs of the product are what determine how much money the organization gets to keep to run its operation and plan for the future and build other things. So separating those costs out from the running the operation, which is much more of a discretionary. You need it, but you don't have to spend it, and if you don't have it, you don't spend it, so you don't spend on the future. Gross margin, operating margin, key. You look for red flags in the notes. When you go through and identify in the income statement, they might tell you things in the notes. Like, for example, one-off. There might be some one-off write-downs. There might be some reversals in some sort of a reserve account, which juices the earnings. In other words, you're reserving a lot for warranty, but you decide you've reserved too much, so you release that. That is actually an increase in earnings. So that is not real. That is something that's coming from the accounting. And therefore, you watch for those things, which would be tagged in the notes. You also want to try to look at time lags, realizing that investment in new products might not have an impact until later. Cutting all of your investments today, not necessarily the best deal, because you have to continue to have new products in the pipeline, as we talked about before.